I think first of all you need to have a natural curiosity to want to push the boundaries of knowledge, to find answers to questions where nobody has ever found an answer before. That's what makes a good physicist, being curious. If I look at the students, when they start their studies, there's a whole range, a spectrum of reasons why they decide to study physics. There are the ones that always want to become a nuclear scientist since they are 6 years old. But then there's also a very large number who are fascinated by physics as such. So that they are fascinated by the fact that there's a subject area that allows you to understand nature better. The physics department has a very proud history of more than 120 years, and it is consistently ranked as one of the top physics departments in the UK and is a global player. One of the unique things we have as a department is that we don't only want you to learn physics, we want you to do physics. So our central teaching laboratories, for example, use the modern equipment that a physicist would use in a research lab or in industry as a professional physicist. And our students, they get access to these setups, to this equipment from the first day that they are on campus. So I think it's that research-led approach where students can get their hands dirty from the first semester onwards that is quite unique to Liverpool. Physics is not an easy subject area, and there are many problems that they have to overcome. So we want students and staff to meet. There is an open door policy, which means that the students, they can ask questions, and we very much encourage them to do this. And I think it's that close interaction between staff and students that really helps to build up a deep understanding of physics, and that also helps to create a very friendly atmosphere. So in the department we have four different research clusters. Condensed matter physics, we develop the next generation of solar cells and photovoltaics. So our experts at the Stevenson Institute for Renewable Energies, they develop the next generation of batteries that will find markets in 5 to 10 years from now. In nuclear science, we are covering a wide range of different activities. We are using antimatter beams, for example. We also develop sensor technologies for nuclear safety, for airport security scanners. In particle physics, we are doing high energy physics experiments. So we are trying to understand the fundamental laws of nature by looking for particles and understanding how they interact. In accelerator science, we contribute to the very large experiments like the Large Hadron Collider at CERN. We develop new instrumentation that allow us to characterize beams of charged particles better than anybody else was ever able to do this before. And we also develop computational tools in order to describe particle beams at facilities all around the world. Liverpool is certainly unique in technology development. So in the infrastructures that we have, our clean room facilities, the workshops, we are one of only very few physics departments in the world actually that can design, assemble, test new equipment and then provide this to the very large experiments all around the world. So I think those students that have a passion for technologies, they find exactly that in the department. They find the environment, they find the infrastructure and the expertise that allows them to be part of the next generation of detectors. In the way that we have teamed up with industry for joint PhD programs, certainly in the way that we are now offering the internships for all of our undergraduate students, we are very unique in the UK and actually in the world. We have lots of events that we organize jointly with industry and companies from the UK and abroad. So we put our students in touch with companies, we create the link, and then we give them all of these opportunities during their degree. To do new science, you need the academic vision, you need crazy ideas to go where nobody else went before. You need the technologies, the capabilities to develop new experiments that can ask these questions. And then you need the partnerships internationally with research organizations and industry that allow you to really make most out of these technologies. And all of this you find here in Liverpool.